Welcome to Championship Wrestling 84. I'm Gordon Soley, your host. And what a match we have upcoming a little bit later on in the day. We're going to be seeing Barry Windham going up against Kendo Nagasaki. You heard me correctly. Barry Windham against Kendo Nagasaki a little bit later on in the program. And Barbara, your take five this week stays with Miami.
That's right. It's the second week of Miami Crisis in Paradise, and I'll be at the Orange Bowl with Mike Rotundo and Barry Windham.
Okay, that's all upcoming a little bit later on. And Buddy, of course, matches tonight in St. Petersburg.
That's right. There'll be return of professional wrestling, NWA wrestling tonight at the Bayfront Center in St. Petersburg. First time in quite some time now. Also in Nassau on May 12th. Big match in the Bahama Islands and Nassau, matches you won't want to miss.
Yeah, right. The Bahamas Tag Team Championship. A little confusion regarding that. Barry Windham had transportation problems getting out of Atlanta. Consequently missed his connection and did not get to the matches this past week. So, Mike Rotundo and Dusty Rhodes won the Bahamas Championship. However, the NWA said because Dusty is the Bahamas heavyweight champion, he can't have both titles. So right now, Mike Rotundo is indeed the Bahama Islands Tag Team Championship. We also have with us today, and certainly a pleasure to have with us, a good friend of ours and a young man who's got quite a career that he's forging ahead for himself, Mike Davis. Mike, welcome aboard.
Thank you very much, Gordon. I'm glad to be here.
We're looking forward to chatting with Mike and getting his expertise and his comments during the matches. We have a match on videotape that I think certainly is deserving of everyone taking a look at. It's a match with Billy Jack taking on Tony D'Amato. Not only is the match extremely impressive, but what happens immediately after the match is over becomes even more impressive, and very frankly, it gives leave to think that, you could see the irresistible force meeting the immovable object. We're going to be taking a look at this tape in just a moment. While we have a second and waiting for that, however, we do have new U.S. Tag Team Champions. We'll tell you more about that a little bit later on. But right now, let's go to this videotape match, Billy Jack against Tony D'Amato.
One tin soldier rides away. So the people of the valley sent a message of the hill asking for help.
All right, the very, very popular Florida heavyweight champion, Billy Jack, getting set to enter the ring, going up against Tony D'Amato. You heard the representative music of Billy Jack as he steps into the ring, displaying the Florida Heavyweight Championship belt. May I point out that on several different occasions, Florida Heavyweight Champions have gone on to become the World Heavyweight Champions, so we've got something going here for this man, Billy Jack, 255 pounds, and rather quick duck under, go behind waist lift, takedown, D'Amato. Trying to get away, and he's got to feel like he's got an octopus on him.
You know, Gordon, I've been here in Florida now for about 12 years. I've seen hundreds of wrestlers come and go. I don't think I've ever seen anyone take Florida by storm with the popularity and the people going for him quite as much as Billy Jack. Seems like Billy Jack just loves everybody there. He doesn't seem to have an enemy in Florida, perhaps except with the exception of some other wrestlers. Now, the man is a great scientific wrestler. Then you take his size and strength and power. I have never yet seen anyone break the full Nelson once this man applies it.
No question about that. D'Amato going for a top wrist lock, and Billy Jack just outpowers him. Billy Jack with a about a 21-inch neck, I would think. Massive forearm. Again, just tremendous body strength. Well-proportioned body strength, I might add. Look at the spinae erecti muscles coursing down along his spinal column. No matter where you look at the man, he is just a tremendously muscled. D'Amato. Cheap shot by D'Amato. Caught Billy Guard off. And Billy Jack. And D'Amato regretting that right now. As Billy Jack closes in on him. And Billy Jack gets the full Nelson. He's got the full Nelson. And Billy Jack shaking D'Amato much like a rat terrier would shake a rat. And man, oh man, oh man, did Billy Jack do a number on D'Amato. Wait a second. Wait a minute. We may have something here. Look at that ringside. Look at ringside. And we may have a confrontation right here. A superstar. Brother. I'll tell you what. If these two get together, if these two meet anywhere, that's going to be the irresistible force meeting the immovable object. What an explosion.
Well, Gordon Soley is going over to ringside to see if he can get a word with Billy Jack. And like he said, a confrontation between these two men will be something for everyone to see. And I'm sure this is just bound to happen because Billy Jack never turns his back, never runs from anyone. And now let's go to Gordon Soley at ringside.
Let me take a second here to chat with the Florida heavyweight champion, Billy Jack. That one cheap shot by D'Amato is what set your temper off.
I don't know what's wrong with these guys. I come out here to wrestle. When the bell rings, we take care of business. Now look it. I can be fresh to wrestle and take on anybody, anytime, any place. No brag, just fat. Gordon, inside the ring is one thing. Outside the ring, I love my people here in Florida. Now the man, and I think you know who I'm referring to when I say the man, if he wants to have a match, full Nelson to full Nelson, weightlifting, arm wrestling, because Gordon, and nobody can break my full Nelson. Nobody has ever broken it yet. I don't think anybody can, because once it's locked in, it can do permanent damage. Now, I seen what the man tried to do earlier to Mike Allen, tried to break his neck. Look it, I'm a little rough too, but I'm not going to break no guy's neck. But the man, if I get the man in the ring, you sign the contract anytime, any place, the man, we're going to get down and get heavy, man. Because I don't like you, I don't like what you stand for, and this is going to end your career, punk.
Thank you so much. Like I said, the irresistible force,
you too, baby,
the immovable object, put those two together. An atomic explosion. Championship wrestling returns to Miami in the Miami Beach Convention Center this coming Wednesday night, May 9th. Match time is 8 p.m. Dusty Rhodes faces the Purple Haze, the loser to leave town. And that match will, of course, highlight the evening of wrestling activity. Blackjack Mulligan and Barry Windham take on Cowboy Ron Bass and Black Bart. In a special challenge match, it will be Billy Jack against Molokai. Two out of three falls, Mike Graham and Mike Rotundo face the Guerrero brothers. Chief Joe Lightfoot's in a no disqualification match against superstar Billy Graham. Mike Davis takes on Kevin Sullivan. In a $2,000 added handicap match, Denny Brown goes up against Mike Fever. And now, here's Barbara Clary.
Miércoles, el 9 de mayo, a las 8 de la noche, en el Centro de Convenciones en Miami Beach, la lucha libre de campeones presentará Dusty Rhodes contra el Purple Haze y seis luchas más. Miércoles, el 9 de mayo, a las 8 de la noche, en el Centro de Convenciones en Miami Beach.
Superstar Billy Graham is with me right now. You're facing Chief Joe Lightfoot, but no disqualification.
You know, it amazes me that this man here would be willing to sign a contract with a stipulation of no disqualification. All that means is simply more pain for the man, more hurt for the man, more injury for the man, more paramedics for the man, more hospital bills, because superstar Billy Graham, martial arts champion of the world, in a no disqualification match, I'm going to go out in the parking lot and rip the bumper off a Cadillac and drag it in the ring and beat you on the head with a bumper from a Cadillac. Superstar Billy Graham, no disqualification. I will choke you. I will choke you literally till you pass out and they'll have to drag you from the ring. No disqualification. Your career, little man, has come to an end at the hands of superstar Billy Graham.
We'll find out Wednesday night.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Syracuse, New York, at 235 pounds, Mike Rotundo. His opponent from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 240 pounds, Kevin Sullivan.
Kevin Sullivan moving out against Mike Rotundo. Buddy Colvin, Mike Davis at the desk with me now, and a beautiful waistcoat takedown by Kevin Sullivan. Man has an extensive amateur background, and of course he's facing a man who's twice All-American out of Syracuse University, Mike Rotundo. Mike Davis, you and Mike Rotundo at one time held the U.S. Tag Team Championship.
That's right, Gordon. You know, Mike and I are very, very close friends, and if Kevin Sullivan came in here for a wrestling match, Mike Rotundo is exactly the man to give it to him, because, you know, two times AAU champion, Mike Rotundo can go in there and he can get the job done.
Well, if there's Kevin Sullivan, the side headlock. Now, this here, to me, is going to be a very even match. Mike Rotundo is no doubt a little bit more of a classic wrestler than Kevin Sullivan. But, however, we cannot underestimate Kevin Sullivan's wrestling ability. The man is very deadly, very powerful. Look at this backslide here on the part of Kevin Sullivan. A possible pinning combination and Mike Rotundo being able to come out. But, like I said, it's going to be a very even, fast-moving match.
As we've mentioned, of course, both men with extensive amateur backgrounds and... Kevin Sullivan, at one time known as a Boston battler, was a Massachusetts amateur champion. And Mike, it looks like your friend Rotundo is in a spot of trouble here.
He's in a head scissors right now. But knowing Mike, even though he's caught in a hold, I know he's thinking about a counter hold. And he should be. Now you can see him right there, Gordon. The man's always thinking and right back into a headlock. Mike Rotundo is one of the most fantastic wrestlers I've ever met in my life.
Kevin Sullivan, a couple of shots into the midsection that time. It was with the inside of the fist, I might add. Sullivan obviously has a lot of respect for Rotundo. Once again, they lock up. Wow! Rotundo rocks him. He rocks him with another bolo-like forearm. Snapmare takes him down outside cradle.
You know, Gordon, you just look at Kevin Sullivan. The man is built like a Sherman tank. Very powerful, very muscular, and... there was a nice counter move on the part of Kevin Sullivan, coming up with a full hammerlock. You know, that's somehow Kevin Sullivan possesses this strange mystical power of being able to manipulate the minds of others, and even with his own words, he's surrounded with black and evil karma, always out to do damage to other people, not just wrestle them, always out to really injure them. Like last week, he showed up, a 15-foot-long python. There's always something new with Kevin Sullivan.
Love it, buddy. He's still... With a man like Mike Rotundo, Kevin Sullivan's got to go in that ring, and no matter what he's possessed by or what kind of karma he's got to be a little leery of Mike Rotundo, because this man can beat you at any time.
Leapfrog by Rotundo, and Rotundo with a good flying drop kick. Rotundo, a beautiful spin under takedown, and again, Sullivan feels the sting of that canvas on his back. Inside armbar now by Rotundo. Rotundo, of course, as I said, he is the Bahamas Tag Team Championship. The franchise, if you will. And talking to my good friend Lou Davies, who was in the Bahamas recently, say a special hi to Tremmy Morris and Michael Higgs over at Valentine's Marina.
As you see right now, Gordon, Mike's got the upper hand on Sullivan, and Sullivan's got to be a little worried. Right there, he has to go to Hairpool to get out of the hole. So you know he's got to be a little leery of Mike Rotundo's talent.
Well, we know that Kevin Sullivan will stop at absolutely nothing to win a match. It's very typical of him when he took Mike Rotundo by the back of the hair and slammed his head into the ring, the turnbuckle there. The turnbuckle is a very solid stop. There's a little padding there, but it can sure do a lot of damage. I can speak from experience on that.
Sullivan caught him. Lariat-like blow to the throat that put Rotundo down. Rotundo powers out before the count of three. Kick out by Rotundo. Go inside, cradle by Rotundo. Sullivan powered away from then used that forearm very effectively. He staggered Rotundo. Catches Rotundo again to the side of the head. And now Sullivan beginning to let out all stops.
Well, Mike Rotundo is in a lot of trouble right now. When Kevin Sullivan gets somebody in a position like this, he stays on. But Mike Rotundo is fighting back. A great second effort there.
He's got Mike's temper up, and that's a bad thing to happen with Rotundo. You know, he's got that Italian temper, and he'll really go after you.
Sullivan caught by Rotundo, the back of the elbow, caught again with that elbow. Again, Sullivan able to power out before the count. Referee Bill Alfonso checking those shoulders. Sullivan turns toward his man, back to his feet. Wow! As Rotundo charged in, Sullivan caught him.
Well, there's not room for many mistakes when you're going up against a man like Kevin Sullivan. But Mike Rotundo is very smart, very cagey wrestler. You never know what to expect from him.
There it is, buddy.
He's got him up in that airplane spin. And couldn't hold it, though. Couldn't hold it. Ha-ha!
Sullivan coming outside.
And it... Ooh!
Wait a minute.
Rotundo.
Wait a minute. I'm not letting him get away with this, Gordon.
Well, Davis down to help Rotundo. Rotundo took that chair right across the top of the head. And Rotundo receiving assistance now from referee Bill Alfonso and Mike Davis. We'll be back. As I mentioned at the beginning of the program, we do have new U.S. Tag Team Champions. They are with us now at ringside, Cowboy Ron Bass and Black Bart, accompanied by, I understand, their manager, the Panama Gang.
That's right, Mr. Sully. You know, I'm proud to be here this afternoon. You know, it's a glorious day to be alive, and I'm going to give you a few reasons why it's nice. First of all, because of the circumstances surrounding J.J. Dillon, I've been cast into the limelight as the number one manager in the state of Florida. Second of all, every day that goes by, this knee is healing. Every day that goes by is closer to the day that Dusty Rhodes will be destroyed. He injured me. He hung a man on nationwide TV. We know it was you, Dusty Rhodes. Every day that goes by, you will be destroyed. You might as well be fitted for an extra large body cast. I'm sending you back to Austin, Texas in a body cast. Thirdly, I'm very proud and honored to be the new manager of the new United States Tag Team Champions. Look at the gold around the waist. Tell them about it, Bassman.
What the hell you like the belts, Gordon Sully? How brand new just delivered to us. And it's just a sign of something to come, Gordon Sully. Whenever Black Bart got here, I said, I've got a partner now. I've got a man that can get in there and get it done. And now then we have proved it. We took Windham and Rotundo, and we beat them from pole to post. And look what the victor got right here, the United States Tag Team Championships. Now we're going to be wrestling champions. We're not going to lay back and hide. Come on out there, all you people that want to put a combination together. The Guerrero brothers, if you want to. Sullivan, you get anybody you want to. Rhodes, Windham, Black Jack Mulligan, Billy Jack, Rotundo. All you got to do is put your name on the line, and myself and Bart will get in the ring and give you an education like you've never had before, baby.
Thank you so very much, gentlemen. We're going to be watching them in action. So let's go to our ring announcer, Bruce Tharp.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is an Australian tag team match. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Oklahoma, Sasa, weighing in at 220 pounds, Mike Allen. And his partner from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, weighing in at 225 pounds, Mike Fever. Their opponents, accompanied to the ring by their manager, Panama Gang, the new United States Heavyweight Tag Team Champions, Cowboy Ron Bass and Black Bart.
All right, introductions having been made, the new U.S. Tag Team Champions, Black Bart and Cowboy Ron Bass. And I wanted to ask Mike Davis, what happened, Mike?
Gordon, I don't know. The first thing I need to do is I've got to apologize to my best friend, Mike Rotundo. You know, this is something that's never happened to me before. I froze. I looked right into the eyes of Kevin Sullivan, and it's like I saw a ghost. I just froze, and I just want to apologize to Mike. I just don't know what happened.
Fair enough. It is Fever giving Black Bart the way to go, and I'll tell you what, these new U.S. Tag Team Champions, that is, I think, given Mike Fever and quite possibly Mike Allen some added impetus, because obviously they can do well against the U.S. Tag Team Champions. It certainly puts them in contention. Cross body block beautifully executed by Fever, broken up.
You know what's really interesting is that the one-man gang had just recently taken over as manager of Cowboy Ron Bass and Black Bart, and already this team is the United States Heavyweight Tag Team Champions, and another title that Black Bart holds. He holds the Brass Knuckles Championship, of which he won from Blackjack Mulligan quite some time ago, and he has successfully defended this on all occasions. So these two men, Black Bart and Ron Bass, is one tough tag team. Mike, I'm sure you've wrestled these men before. What do you think of them?
I've wrestled both of these men, buddy, and they're both double tough. They wrestle, they can fight, they do it all, you know, and when you got two big men, you're looking at two guys that are over 300 pounds, and you've got to go in there and you've got to have a lot of speed to beat them. But Ron Bass and Black Bart are two of the toughest champions I've ever seen.
Well, you can say that again. When you get two men like that, each weighing in the neighborhood of 300 pounds, and a 450-pound manager and the one-man gang, or now Panama gang, that's quite an awesome trio.
Well, it's always, you know, when you got Panama gang on the outside, you can always look at it as three against two.
Tag is made. Mike Allen in trouble on the canvas, and Cowboy Ron Bass, man from Pampas, Texas, brings him out. There's that Texas Stampede. Count of three. The count of three. So the U.S. Tag Team Champions emerge victorious, referring to Black Bart and Cowboy Ron Bass. Well, in just a moment or two, we're going to be seeing...
Gordon, excuse me. I just feel really ill. I need to excuse myself. Thank you.
Well, strange. Apparently not feeling well. Well, as I said, of course, in a moment, we're going to be seeing superstar Billy Graham in action. And I see him approaching the desk at this time. Well, let's see what's on superstar Billy Graham's mind this week.
Superstar Billy Graham right here live and in color. This morning I ripped a bumper off a Mack truck. Superstar Billy Graham, I ripped a fender off a brand new Cadillac with this arm right here. This arm, 22 and a half inches from the back side, 22 and three-fourths from the front side. Superstar Billy Graham live on television last week offered a challenge to arm wrestle any living human being, a living or alive, makes no difference. I issued a challenge to the Tampa Bay Bucks, Miami Dolphins, to the Bandits, Jacksonville Bulls. Any human being wants to arm wrestle Superstar Billy Graham, my arm is here. I got no recipients. You understand? No one has answered my challenge. Nobody around here in the Everglades has got any guts. Everybody's afraid to grab hold of this arm. My challenge has come unanswered. Even the big man, the American Dream, won't get next to my arm. Even that big kid, Barry Windham, and I know he's on anabolic steroids for a fact. I know that. And this is the Olympic year. I know that for a fact, the man's on anabolic steroids. And he won't even come out here and grab a hold of this 22-inch arm. And the man with the full Nelson, the man with the beard, you understand, and the full Nelson, the man will come out here and lock up with superstar Billy Graham. Why? Because I am the strongest. I am the greatest. I'm the man of the hour, the man with the power. Too sweet to be sour. Give me some music. I got to get to the game. I got to pick him up there.
Well, there you have it, superstar Billy Graham proceeding to move out toward the ring. And our camera following him all the way, walking along resolutely. Let's turn it over to our ring announcer, Bruce Thorpe.
In fact, it was a little bit frightening.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match won foul with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Honolulu, Hawaii, weighing in at 215 pounds, Denny Brown. His opponent from Paradise Valley, Arizona, at 255 pounds, superstar Billy Graham.
Superstar Billy Graham going up against Denny Brown. By the way, this will be the final time that you'll be seeing Bruce Thorpe here on Championship Wrestling 84. Bruce is going on to get his law degree. Recently graduated and is now going on to get his law degree, so we certainly want to wish him the very, very best. He's going to be sorely missed. He's an outstanding ring announcer and referee. There's the bell. Superstar Graham moving out against Denny Brown. Quite a difference in size and height here, buddy, but Brown has got a tremendous amount of fighting.
Well, Dennis Brown is an exceptional basic wrestler. His style is very good. Now, however, you can't lock up with a man like Superstar Billy Graham like this. Billy Graham is too big, too strong. Dennis Brown's going to have to outmaneuver him, outthink him, and just outsmart him. And so far, he's not outthinking him or outsmarting him. What's also interesting is that Billy Graham is constantly issuing challenges for arm wrestling. I would like to remind Billy Graham that this is professional wrestling. This is not arm wrestling. He challenged Dusty Rhodes and Barry Windham. But here he's got that...
He's got the full Nelson, buddy. He's got it on him, and Denny Brown is helpless at this point. Helpless and hapless, I might add. There is no way to escape from that full Nelson. And Brown thrust aside like a sack of potatoes. And Superstar Billy Graham, very pleased with himself, but he is indeed the winner of this match. Championship wrestling will be held this coming Wednesday night in Miami Beach at the Miami Beach Convention Center. Match time is 8 p.m. In a loser-leave town match, it will be the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, against the Purple Haze. Blackjack Mulligan and Barry Windham take on Cowboy Ron Bass and Black Bart. Special challenge match, Billy Jack faces Molokai. In a 2-out-of-3-falls match, Mike Graham and Mike Rotundo face Chavo and Hector Guerrero. In a no-disqualification match, Superstar Billy Graham faces Chief Joe Lightfoot. Mike Davis takes on Kevin Sullivan. And in a $2,000 added handicap match, Dennis Brown against Mike Fever. I'll take a moment now to talk to Barry Windham. You and your dad facing a tough combination in Ron Bass and Black Bart.
That's right, Gordon. You know, it's been a long time since Blackjack was in town, but now he's back. And he has something on his mind. And Ronnie Bass is exactly it. You know, how it got into this tag team situation, I don't know. But I made a promise to him. I told him that I would take care of Black Bart and he would get a hold of Ronnie Bass and get something taken care of that he's wanted to for a long time. So, Ronnie Bass, you'd watch out because he's coming at you.
Thank you so very much, Barry Windham. Well, the Panama Gang and Kevin Sullivan have some comments.
The new United States Tag Team Champions right there is where it happened. Black Jack Mulligan, Barry Windham had his partner there. He couldn't do the job, so he calls up his old man, Black Jack. Hey, Dad, how about coming down? We got a match in Miami Beach. Would you be my partner against Cowboy Ron Bass and Black Bart? Barry says, I promise you, Dad, I'll take care of Black Bart. Well, Barry, don't promise the man anything. Tell him about what you're going to do to Mulligan.
You understand, trouble's back in town. When I say trouble, I'm talking about one Black Jack Mulligan. But Mulligan, just your big stature, just your reputation, just whatever anybody's ever heard of big Black Jack Mulligan, it don't make us run and hide. We're not afraid of you, Mulligan. I fought you once, and I'll fight you again. I'll probably fight you again.
So you bring your little snot-nosed kid, that little Barry Windham. And by the way, Windham, how did you like your ride last week, huh? Did you enjoy that? Well, you come on, boys, because there's more waiting on you. Because Barry and Bart, we just started, brother.
Bring your snack box, Barry Windham, because you got a long way to go before you can take care of Black Bart.
The Haze is coming to Miami Beach. Loser leaf town, 60 days. They ain't taking no bets in Vegas on this one because last week the golden spike went right in your heart, Rhodes.
How you ever got up and how they didn't fit you for a pine box, I don't know.
This time, Miami, you are calling all your people, all creeds, all colors.
Well, there's only one Purple Haze, and after Wednesday night, there'll be no more Dusty Rhodes. It is a crisis for you in Miami, and I'm going to make sure as hell that you end up going to paradise!
Dusty Rhodes realizes full well the importance of this situation.
God, I was in a lot of pain. Mulligan and myself both know the situation that happened.
He caught the golden spike.
what he calls his time. It was sent to him at this time in his life to go ahead and overcome good. Now, whether you be of any race, creed, or color, or wherever you're from in the Miami area, we got to all come down on this one.
I want it over before it starts, the purple haze. Yes, I do, yes, I do, yes, I do. The golden spike did leave its mark, but nothing like the mark left on my heart inside. Miami Beach is golden, boy, that's the real American dream. Miami Beach is paradise, its leader. The man who will walk with no shoes in the coming month through the streets of Miami will face the purple haze in my final conflict. And whether there's karma on my house, be it bad or good, there is nothing but bad karma in my heart right now for Kevin Sullivan and the purple haze. Let's end it before it starts. Me or him, God and soul, me or him.
It'll happen Wednesday night, Convention Center.
With a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing in at 250 pounds, Barry Windham. His opponent from the Far East, weighing in at 265 pounds, the Black Ninja, Kendo Nagasaki.
This is the match we've been waiting for. Barry Windham moving out against Kendo Nagasaki. One fall, 8 10-minute time limit. And here's the match that would fill an arena anywhere. By the way, those of you in Immokalee, watch out. Dusty Rhodes is coming your way.
Well, there's Kendo Nagasaki with a quick headlock on Barry Windham, and down goes Barry. Very smartly dropping down. It looked like he might have tried for an lariat there, but right over the head. And a big high drop kick, and Barry Windham coming out on top, and Kendo Nagasaki bailing out to get his win back. That's right, Gordon just said the big match is May 11th with headline by Dusty Rhodes in Immokalee, Florida.
All right, Barry Windham now with an armbar on Kendo Nagasaki, has him to the canvas. Bill Alfonso, the referee, circling him and watching him carefully. Nagasaki pulls him back to the ropes. And may I just assure all of you out there who follow the career of Barry Windham, he is not on the steroids as superstar Billy Graham accused him of. He is not, I repeat. So please bear that thought in mind.
There's Barry Windham with his full arm bar on Kendo Nagasaki. You see the intensity on his face. He's putting that pressure on. But Kendo Nagasaki is a very dangerous opponent, being so well versed in the martial arts as well as professional freestyle wrestling. There's Barry with that big forearm right into the armpit there. Well, it's like Kendo trying to take a cheap way of making a counter move here by pulling the back of the hair.
Windham keeps the pressure on, drives Nagasaki back to the canvas once again. Windham boring in with that full 240 pounds across the back of Nagasaki, and now drives that knee into the biceps and triceps of Nagasaki. He is going to try and render that left arm useless if he can, buddy.
Well, it's really a smart thing to do. A very good, smart cagey wrestler will always try and work on the same part of the body. There is no sense or reasoning to go from a hammerlock to a headlock to a step-over toe hold. That way you can never completely annihilate any certain part. A smart wrestler always picks out one part of the body and tries to make that a weak part. If you're out without one of your legs, without one of your arms, that's losing 25% of your ability. And when you're in this top professional wrestling, you have to have every part of your body in terrific condition at all times. But there's a big karate kick upside the upper chest of Barry Windham. Fortunately, Barry might have saw that coming and stepped out. If it caught him in the throat, it would have been all over.
Nagasaki becoming a bit desperate here and was choking Barry Windham. Nagasaki into that strange spin and lashes out a savate-like kick into the chest. Catches Windham in those nerve centers on either side of the neck.
These Oriental wrestlers are quite adept at the nerve centers. Everybody has a lot of nerve centers throughout there, and these little pressure points, you hit these pressure points and it can just about partially and temporarily paralyze that section of the body. And Kendo Nagasaki is well-versed in that.
Irish whip off the ropes on Barry Windham, and again, Kendo Nagasaki using those feet so very effectively. And Barry Windham outside the ring on the concrete, coming up rather slowly. What a battle these two have had. Both of these men are main eventers, and Windham going up on that second rope. Third rope caught him coming off the ropes. Got the pinfall. He got the pinfall. Brother Barry Windham, who looked like he was in a lot of trouble, caught him beautifully and scored the pinfall. The winner, Barry Windham.
Miami Crisis in Paradise. Last week, as I was talking with promoter Chris Dundee, he mentioned that they'd like to get championship wrestling back in the Orange Bowl. Well, it has happened. The Lords of the Ring are coming June 30th to the Orange Bowl. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank Red Top Limousines on behalf of Dusty Rhodes, Barry Windham, and Mike Rotundo. We had a great time in Miami. Now let's see some sights in Miami and go to the Orange Bowl with Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo. I'm here at the Orange Bowl with Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo to find out how they feel about Miami.
You know, Barbara, you know, right now, here at the Orange Bowl, it's been said that there's going to be a major attraction here at the Orange Bowl as far as championship wrestling from Florida is concerned. And Mike Rotundo and I right now are trying to sign for a match on the card whenever it comes here to the to Orange Bowl. And, you know, we've been talking about it a long time. It's going to be one of the biggest things to ever happen here in Miami. And, you know, Mike and I, we travel so much, but we stop here in Miami whenever we can. We've almost made this our second home. Me being from Texas, you know, I have to have a place to stop along the road, and Miami is one of my favorite places to be.
Mike, how do you feel about Miami?
It's great. It's kind of a significant place for me, Barbara, because a few short years ago, I played football here while I was at Syracuse University. I've wrestled amateur in the state of Florida and in Miami in tournaments, and now I'm going to get a chance to come right here in the Orange Bowl because Barry and I are looking forward to signing some contracts. We're going to come right here, and for championship wrestling in Miami, it's going to be number one, and I'm just proud to be a part of it, and like Barry and I are signing that tag team title, putting it on the line right here in the Orange Bowl, and we hope it's full because I'd love all the fans in Miami to come down here and really see part of the Orange Bowl in a different fashion than they're used to.
Well, it's great wrestling in a great place. Miami, crisis or paradise?
Jalisco, 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 tú tienes tu novia, es Guadalajara. Muchacha bonita, la perla más rara, de todo Jalisco es mi Guadalajara.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match, one foul with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from the Great Northwest Territory at 220 pounds, Wild Bill Snyder. His opponent, from Mexico City, Mexico, at a weight of 222 pounds, Hector Guerrero.
Hector and Chavo Guerrero in the ring. It's Hector Guerrero who will be wrestling. Chavo obviously will not be wrestling, but he stays very close to his brother. Hector going up against Wild Bill Snyder. One fall with television time remaining. Should be a good, fast-moving match, buddy.
Well, you know, this Hector Guerrero is excitement personified. This man is always an exciting, colorful, it looks like his brother Chavo slapped him in the face there to try and get him psyched up. It doesn't take much to get the Guerrero brothers psyched up. While Bill Snyder backing him into the ring ropes there, the referee calling for a break. While Bill Snyder, of course, improving with every match, always going after the very best wrestlers, which is the only way to get to the top. Wrestle the best, and you learn more, get more experience. And it is a good body slam right there, and down goes Hector Guerrero.
Snyder back in with a quick snap there and a front shot. Good escape by Hector Guerrero. The Guerrero brothers, I understand, generally eat anywhere from 3 to 4 jalapeno peppers before they go into a match. I don't know whether it has a psychological effect or what, but brother, they are a fast-moving pair in the ring. Bill Snyder catching him a good forearm to the midsection.
Well, you can see Hector Guerrero there grabbing Wild Bill Snyder around the throat on the dark side of the referee. Of course, the referee cannot see everything, and if he doesn't see it, he can't call it. Referee down for a count, Wild Bill Snyder coming out. There is Hector Guerrero coming up with a front face lock. This can be, do some damage right here. This can be a painful hold.
Front chancery and trapping the left arm and the head of Wild Bill Snyder. And Chavo Guerrero approaching our desk.
Let me tell you something. I know there's some new U.S. champions, but that's all right. It doesn't matter if it's Black Bart and Bass or Windham, or it doesn't matter. We're still after the U.S. Tag Team Champions, and we need to get them. I'm talking to my lawyers. I've gone to the consulate in Miami, Florida, to the Mexican consulate, so they can do something. They're trying. They're staying away from us. They're scared of us. But as you can see, my ferocious brother here, he is getting, look at that, the power that he's got. Sooner or later, Mr. Soli, Mr. Colt, we're going to get those belts, and then don't let nobody fool you about that.
All right, the comments from Chavo Guerrero. And obviously, they want very much to gain those U.S. Tag Team Championship belts.
Well, you know, Gordon, that would be an interesting match. The Guerrero brothers against the tag team of Black Bart and Cowboy Ron Bass. The Guerrero, Chavo, you said, he doesn't care who has him. He wants a match, and that's a match that I would like to see.
The monumental explosion, no question about that. Wild Bill Snyder retaliating now on Hector Guerrero, and he's got him staggered. He's got him staggered. Snyder's got an opportunity here. Snyder now continues to pound away with that right hand, and Guerrero has been staggered, and now a snapmare takes him to the canvas. A lateral press.